오늘 좋은 아침 3부 초대석 시간에는 성영준 캐롤튼 시의원과 커미셔너, 달라스 커미셔너 JJ 쿡 씨와 함께하는 시간으로 꾸며보도록 하겠습니다. 이 자리에 두 분 나와 계세요. 안녕하세요.
Hello, how
안녕하세요.
are you? Welcome.
Good morning.
Good morning. 네, 너무 반갑습니다. 여기 아주 멋진 신사분 두 분을 모시고 오늘도 또 즐거운 이야기, 또 여러 가지 지금 화제가 되고 있는 이야기들을 다뤄볼 텐데요. 먼저 본인 소개 부탁드릴게요.
Oh, thank you so much for coming here. She said you look handsome, county commissioner. So welcome. So please introduce yourself, sir.
My name is JJ Koch. I'm the county commissioner for District 2 here in Dallas County.
Okay. 그러니까 그 JJ Cook, 그 Dallas County Commissioner 이 구역.
네, 이 구역에서. 네. 네. 그러시고 뭐 개인적으로 또 본인 소개를 더 하시고 싶은 거 있으면.
Do you have anything about personal? A little bit personal, please share with us.
Oh, sure. I've been in Dallas County now in the city of Dallas proper since 2002, and fortunately though I've been a lifelong Dallas Cowboys fan. So like many people growing up in a household where they had someone that was a fan of America's team, didn't matter where you grew up, you were going to be a Cowboys fan. So you know, a lot of folks will say that they got down to Texas as fast as they could. They apologize for not having been born here. I count myself amongst those, and certainly a big part of that was making sure that I was close enough to the Cowboys to support them all the time.
Oh. Wow, that's right. Yeah, that's Cowboys. Jimmy Jones. Without the Jimmy Jones, I don't think they're gonna win a Super Bowl again. But
you have to start my day like that. Oh.
I love Jimmy Jones. The Super Bowl.
Yeah. 네, 네.
예, 그러니까 2002년도부터 여기 달라스를 살았는데요. 달라스 카우보이가 진짜 굉장히 huge fan이라고 합니다. 팬인데 그 달라스 카우보이 어디를 가든 달라스 카우보이를 신경 쓰고 그.
네, 네. 그러니까 찐팬이신 거죠.
예.
진짜 그러실 것 같은데, 자 그렇다면은 이제 여기 달라스 카운티 커미셔너 이 지역에서 지금 커미셔너로 일을 하고 계신다고 했는데 언제부터 일을 시작하신 건지.
So you were the commissioner for Dallas County for Place 2, District 2.
Yeah, District 2.
So, could you tell us when you started and how it's going so far?
Sure. Well, how it's going so far is pretty interesting. But I started in 2019, swore in January 1st, 2019, and had a heck of a start. It was a lot of opportunities to change some of the basic things that we did within Dallas County. So that first year was a lot of kind of helping renew some efforts and just kind of bring new eyes to a lot of things, because the other members of the court had been there for quite some time.
Yeah.
Mm. Then, of course, in the fall of 2019, we had a big tornado come through a portion of Dallas County, and a lot of that was the city of Dallas, and we had to respond to it. Had a great opportunity to respond and help folks, and I remember thinking to myself after that, well, I've shown the voters that I can respond to crisis. And there's a saying that, you know, man plans and God laughs, because there I was thinking that I've totally shown the voters that I can respond in a crisis. And then coronavirus comes 3 months later, and I have another wonderful opportunity to show that I can respond in crisis. Yeah. But it has been a lot of crisis, but it also has been a tremendous opportunity to fix a lot of the things that are systemically broken in Dallas County. I think folks do a better job of understanding that their government needs to be very effective when there is a crisis. So crisis gives us an opportunity to fix how we do things and make things better.
Yes, yeah, so we heard he's doing wonderful job. So.
네, 네. 네.
그러니까 그 제로 그 선서 돼가지고 이 1월 2019 날 19년도 시작을 했습니다. 네. 근데 바로 보면은 가을에 2019년도에 토네이도가 있었잖아요.
그러니까요.
여기 보시면 저 뒤에서도 보면은 이쪽에서 9개의 그 토네이도가 있었는데
네, 네.
그런 일이 있었는데 이런 크라이시스가 있는데 이것을 리스폰드 해가지고 마무리를 잘 하고 있는데
네,
그 다음에 3개월 후에 그때 코로나가 또 터졌습니다.
그렇죠.
이 팬데믹 네. 터졌는데도 이것을 또 한번 크라이시스가 있으면 이 아파트는 기회가 있다고 하면서 이것을
그러니까 그걸 또 이렇게 기회다 하고 위기를 또 잘 넘겼다 그러는데
예.
이제 처음으로 그렇게 선출이 되시고 나서 이런 아주 대형 사실 큰 재난들이 일어난 거잖아요.
예.
이거를 이렇게 기회라고 생각하기까지 어떤 이렇게 좀 너무 이거 내가 감당할 수 있을까? 내가 잘해낼 수 있을까? 그런 두려움들은 없었을까? 궁금해요.
I mean, yeah, I mean, it's incredible. You said so. You know, soon as you got sworn in, this thing crisis and this happened. It says it's crisis. I mean, I know it says it's an opportunity to show the voters that you are capable and you have done fantastic job. But did you not have some fear on this?
No. and here's why. You know. You recognize that most people will go to sleep at night mm-hmm. and not know what can they do tomorrow to make things better.
Yeah.
Every night when I go to sleep, I know there's something I can do to make things better, and I have a list of them. It's my to-do list. I have to call HHS back to make sure someone gets tested. I have to reach out to another agency to make sure the vaccine gets to a certain group that needs to get vaccinated. So I always have something to do to chip away at the problem. So it's very hard to be afraid
yeah.
when you always know there's something, there's a next step, there's another bite you can take out of the thing to help folks.
Except that you have a servant heart to do so. Yes. 그러니까 이것을 보면은 그 한번 잠 잘 때마다
네.
아무튼 힘들겠지만 어렵지만 뭐 그 다음에 뭘 할 수 있는다 뭐 해들었 사람이 이게 팬데믹 때 백스네이션을 할 때 어떻게 해서
네, 네.
불러가지고 연락을 해가지고 또 이 도와줄 수 있는가 이런 마음과 항상인데 두려움이 없다 두려워할
네.
시간이 없다
네 준비를 항상 하고 있다라는
예.
거죠
예.
네 그러고 사실은 이 달라스 카운티의 뭐 코로나 확진율도 굉장히 높았고 사실 어려움들이 많았잖아요 그러면서 지금 현재 상황 질병통제예방센터에서 이제 실내에서 마스크 착용을 다시 권고하고 있단 말이에요.
네.
달라스 카운티도 COVID-19 위험 수준을 오렌지로 업그레이드 했는데 카운티 수준에 어떤 검역 지침이 있는지 네, 이제 본격적인 좀 질문을 드려볼게요.
Well, I mean, you had a, you know, it was a, you know, crisis pandemic happened. You know, there's a lot of vaccination, a lot of crisis, a lot of things happening. So now it's something, now Delta virus is coming back again. So there was a mask mandate. And do you have any concern about this future? How is that preventing maintenance? Or are you thinking ahead about the mask, other things, the precautionary things, or are you thinking of?
Yeah, I think it's helpful to think of it as a different phase that will have a lot of the same solutions brought forward to this time, but we do need to think about it in a different construct, if you will, right? There are more people that have either had the virus or have been vaccinated. We know that in both instances, whether you have had the virus or been vaccinated, you can still be infected by the Delta variant.
Yeah.
And in all likelihood, you know, when we're all the way to the Omega variant, you will still be vulnerable to it as well.
Yeah.
But knowing that, right, we know that it is more difficult to transmit to folks that either have had the virus or are vaccinated. And, you know, there's kind of a smaller population of people that are still there for the fire to spread, if you will.
Right.
So that informs me as a policymaker to say that I've got to do my best to slow down transmission amongst those that still can and try to, you know, eliminate as quickly as possible the population that still is either unvaccinated or they haven't, you know, naturally received the virus. I hope that rather than naturally receiving, they choose a vaccine because that's a better way to do it.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. 그러니까 이 바이러스를 가지고 있고 맞고 그 백신 받았지만 이제 앞으로 델타가 있을 수 있고 그다음에 그 더 큰 문제가 있을 거 오메가가 가져올 수 있다는
그렇죠.
하지만 그런데 거기서 그 백신 안 받은 사람들 위해서 그 자연적으로 생각을 하지 말고 미리 준비를 해 가지고 와서 맞게끔 하고
그러니까 뭐 자연 항체가 생길 때까지 기다리는 것이 아니라 미리 좀 지금 확산이 너무 심하게 되고 있으니까 이제 좀 백신을 맞으면 좋겠다. 그런 걸 더 조금 이렇게 권고하고 그런다는 거죠.
그렇죠.
네, 네. 아, 쉽지 않을 것 같습니다. 왜냐면 사실 이 한국과는 좀 정서가 달라서 개인의 자유가 되게 많이 이렇게 존중이 되는 나라다 보니까 한 명 한 명을 설득해서 이렇게 백신을 맞게 하고 그러는 것들이 참 힘들 것 같은데 그런 면에서 이제 사람들을 설득하고 그런 것이 참 많이 힘들지 않을까라는 생각이 들어요.
I mean, like other countries, you know, when the government mandates that they try to follow, but because we have so much freedom in America, which is a great thing to have a freedom, but sometimes to try to have those people unvaccinated, try to have them to naturally inviting the friendly way to do it is very challenging for you. Mm-hmm. And I know it's tough, but how do you handle something like that?
Yeah, no, it is extremely challenging. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when we look at cultures along a spectrum, right? Yeah. You have the individualist culture, mm-hmm. you know, the full individualist culture, which does not exist anywhere in the world. Yeah. Right. And on the other side, you have the, you know, full communitarian type culture, mm-hmm. where you're, you know, very tightly knit communities and you never step outside mm-hmm. what the community wants, mm-hmm. right? Well, you know, the United States, of course, is over here. A lot of the Asian communities are, you know, further mm-hmm. on that side of the spectrum. And I think it's important that, you know, we as Americans look to the types of things that we see that, you know, we can mm-hmm. Include mm-hmm. in our daily lives, because it really is, it's a cultural shift, mm-hmm. right? We're never going to get to a place where the government can mandate right. this, you know, the legal structure is not built such,
right?
Our rule of law is such that, you know, it keeps the individual's rights pristine, and it has its incredible advantages mm-hmm. commercially and otherwise, but right. as we see in crises like this,
mm-hmm.
it has tremendous disadvantages. Mm-hmm. So it'll be important for people like myself to get on the soapbox
mm-hmm.
and say, listen, I cannot force you to get a vaccine. Mm. But for, you know, the love that I have for you and your family, mm. I certainly want you to consider it. I certainly want you to do it if you have decided to do it. Now, that's the biggest part that the government has to make sure to take care of. If you have decided, I want to get a vaccine,
right.
there can be no friction. I must get that to you as quickly as possible. That is my duty.
Right.
I must do that.
Right. So also, it's, when you talk about the family, it's also the right thing for your family. That's what you want to convey the message as well.
It's really time to start talking about it in terms of community and family. Mm-hmm. You know, we talk about the individual decision, and mm-hmm. yes, it's an individual decision.
Yes.
There are those that like to talk about, well, it's your obligation to the community. Well, the community for the American mindset, for the most part, is just amorphous. It's a thing, and why do I care about those folks? I care about my family.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I care about those close to me. I care about my school. I care about. Look, we've got to start talking about and talking in terms of let's look at our communities.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
아, 그러니까 굉장히 그 이 자유 나라가 있다 보니까
네.
문화도 이 다른
문화도 다르고
문화도 많은 다르
출신들도 다 다르고
다 다르기 때문에 근데 네. 제일 중요한 게 뭐냐 이 미국이라고 하면은 미국 사람은 안 자유도 좋지만 이 가족 내 가족을 위해서 나 먼저 생각을 한다면 내 가족도 생각하고 제일 가까운 곳 하면은 그거부터 생각을 하면 이게 커뮤니티로도 할 수 있는 마음을 그 말씀 드려
그러니까 개인의 자유보다는 나와 연관된 가족 또 네. 나와 연관된 사회 네. 나와 연관된 학교 직장 네. 이런 전체 커뮤니티를 생각하는 마음 으로 더 예. 이렇게 권고하고 있다라고.
예, 그리고 고의적으로 할 수 없지만
그렇죠. 네, 네. 맞습니다. 참 큰일하고 계신 것 같고요. 그러면은 지금 이제 굉장히 중요한데 중요하고 제가 좀 알고 싶은데 달라스 카운티 현재 예방 접종률은 어느 정도인지 알고 싶거든요.
Yeah, well, so yes. Thank you so much for that. It's again, you're doing fantastic job during this challenging time. We're grateful for your service. But can you tell us about the vaccination rate right now in Dallas County?
Yeah, it's not wonderful. So for those that are 12 years old and older, mm-hmm. right, we have a vaccination rate of 58%. Mm-hmm. You know, I really think success right now would look more like 70%.
Mm-hmm.
So we haven't done our job. You know, and it is incumbent upon all of us to convince all those that are convincible, because mm-hmm. there's always going to be a remainder that are not. And not only is it the convincing job, but then also there are still some in our county mm-hmm. that want to get vaccinated mm-hmm. and are struggling to get to that vaccination.
Mm-hmm.
So that number should look a lot more like our over 65 number. So for those that are over 65 in Dallas County, 84%. are vaccinated.
Wow.
So our most vulnerable, we're in a good spot, right? But we're starting to see certainly more severe illness amongst our 40-year-olds and, you know, those that are mothers and fathers, right? Those that are in their most productive years. And there was a term that was coined during the Spanish influenza, and it was, someone said, these are double deaths. Someone's doubly dead. Not only, you know, have we lost the individual, but we've lost the 40 years of life that we still would have had in that 30-year-old.
맞아요. Wow.
Yeah, right. That's right.
네, 네.
아, 그러니까 그 백신레이션 하는 레이트가 보면은 12살 넘게 보면은 58%고요.
네.
55세가 넘은 그 연세 드신 분들은 84%지만
네.
근데 요새 보면은 이제 40대 어머님, 아버님 그 나이 30대, 40대가 지금 그 이 바이러스 하면은 근데 그 너무 아쉬운 게
네네. 그 지금 이분들이 더 많이 맞으셔야 되는데
그렇죠. 그러니까 그 다 하는데 더 이게 지금 도전 생겨가지고
그렇죠.
안 맞으려고 하는 사람도 있고 맞아. 그런데 그 인플루엔자 한데 그 스페인 인플루엔자 그때 보면은 40대가 된 분이 40살 더 살 수가 있는데 그때 돌아가셨다는 게 그 더블리 데스 더블 두 번 그런 말씀을 좀
그러니까 스페인 독감 때도 좀 비슷하지 않느냐라는 예. 이제 그런 말씀을 하시면서 사실은 왕 성하게 활동하고 있는 지금 젊은 엄마 아빠들 세대들이 더 많이 좀 맞아줘야 되는데 사실 접종률은 조금 낮다, 그게 조금 아쉽다라는 말씀하신 것 같아요. 그렇죠. 그렇다면 이제 백신 접종률을 막 높여야 되잖아요. 그러면은 다른 주와 마찬가지로 어떤 좀 이벤트 같은 게 좀 있을까요?
Yeah, so, I mean, though you still want to vaccinate many people as well, and more people as well, even though you have this this percentage up there, but other states are doing encouraging. What would you do encourage to come forward to these people to vaccinate so that they'll get they won't get be get this virus.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, the first thing, of course, is just to reduce any friction that can exist, right? So if someone has a transportation issue, if someone, you must get the vaccination clinics toward the individuals that, you know, and if we need to stop at people's doorsteps with a van, you know, if someone's willing, hey, listen, I can't get out of my house. I'm, you know, severely disabled or very elderly. There still are some of those folks that we must get to get that done. So that's job number one. That would be low-hanging fruit, if you will, right? I mean, it's absolutely silly to not handle those things first. And then, you know, community events and people that are already tied to a community. They've already self-identified as someone that I care about these folks that are standing around me. When they're in that room with the people they care about, let them know. If you're not vaccinated, all these people that you care about could be at risk because of you. So, right outside, we have our vaccinations. Go get your first one and then come back here around all the people that you love and care for here in 30 days and get the second one.
아 그러니까 보면은 이제 그 나이 드신 분, 장애인들이 그 집에 나갈 수 없는 분,
그러니까 사실은 백신을 맞으러 가는 게 힘들죠.
그죠, 가는 게 힘들기 때문에 그 집으로 가서 이렇게끔 하는 그 하나의 방법이 있고 그 다음에 그 교통 때문에 못 하는 것을 너무 도와주겠다.
네, 라이드도 해주시고요.
그렇죠, 라이드 해주고 그 다음에 그 커뮤니티 이벤트를 해가지고 거기에서 야. 안 받았으면 이거 하자. 그다음 30일에 가서 다시 받을 수 있게끔 할 것을 얘기를 계속 얘기를 해야죠.
그러면은 노 로터리인가요? 왜 다른 주에서는 로터리도 막 이렇게 주고 막 그러잖아요.
No, so like other states now doing all kind of the the fun stuff like a lottery system, pay money for all that stuff. Like, any good stuff that
you know, I always like a bit of circus, right? But I will say that I think the one tough thing about being in government is that there's a certain level of like dignity. Yes. You know, we present ourselves soberly and scientifically.
Yes.
And the only problem, or I have a couple problems with raffles, but you know, I want someone to have made the decision based on their understanding of the science, the people that have, you know, advised them. And that's kind of the best way to get to the decision. I know that they're going to follow through with it. I know that, you know, they're going to be willing to accept some negative consequences should they arise, right?
Right.
It is, the vaccine is overwhelmingly safe. It is safer than many vaccines that have ever been out there. But, but there's a small chance that someone will be harmed. I don't want to sell someone on taking that vaccine for a raffle ticket. I want them to think about it scientifically and say, okay, I accept the risk. I know that I'm going to greatly, you know, help other people. That it, you know, as my conscience requires me to make that sale in the hard way, not the I'm going to give you free stuff way.
네, 네.
아니 그러니까 로또라고 합니까? 그냥 라돌이.
복권.
복권을 그렇게 하는 것보다도 완전히 그 서커스처럼 생각하는 것 같아요. 진짜 진심으로 정치적으로 이제 과학적으로 봐가지고 아무튼 이 백스는 좀 안전하지만 거기서 작은 그 한 불태지가 좀 그 위험이 있을 수 있지만 또 이게서 안전하기 때문에 와서 꼭 하시라는 그런 말씀을 하시죠.
네, 제가 지금 조금 impressive했던 게 이지웨이를 가는 게 아니고 약간 하드웨이긴 하지만 정석으로 가고 싶다라는 느낌이 드는 거예요. 일회성 이벤트보다 과학적인 근거를 가지고 자신의 판단에 따라서 의지적으로 움직이는 것이 더 옳은 길이 아닌가라는 말씀을 하신 것 같은데.
Yes, it's just, it's just very impressive what you said about it's not taking the easy way. It's doing the hard way, doing the right way and the scientific way.
Yeah. Well, growing up, I was a wrestler. I wrestled in college.
Really?
My life is all about, you know, do the hard things because you'll always end up getting it right. If the easy way is there and it looks too easy, it is.
아, 그러니까 그 대학교에서 그 레슬링 선수였어요.
아니, 그러니까 저 지금 깜짝 놀랐어요.
그러니까 그러니까 항상 쉽게 가면은 쉬운 거다. 그러니까 어렵게 가더라도 옳게 가고 제대로 하는 게 좋다는 말씀입니다.
아, 진짜 스포츠맨십까지 딱 가지고 진짜 멋지시네요. 저희 잠깐 브레이크 타임 갖도록 하겠습니다.
Yes.
오늘 좋은 아침 초대석 시간에는 성영준 캐롤튼 시의원과 달라스 커미셔너로 지금 일하고 계신 JJ 쿡 모시고 여러 가지 팬데믹 상황에서 달라스 카운티가 어떻게 대처해 나가고 있는지에 대해서 이야기를 나눠봤는데요. 저희가 잠시 브레이크 시간에 사실 성 의원님 이런 얘기를 나눠봤잖아요. 유럽이 좋은 본보기가 되고 있다. 먼저 시작이 돼서 우리가 좀 이런 것들을 준비하고 예방할 수 있다라는 얘기를 했잖아요. 그런 거에 대해서 간략하게 그래서 여러 가지 너무 두려워할 필요는 없다라는 이제 그런 말씀을 해주셨잖아요.
Well, briefly we talked about it during the break. The Europe, they starts from Europe and we take a good thing, so what they do and then take it from there and they're not doing the bad things. So that's kind of good things. Can you share with us a little bit about that?
Mm-hmm. Sure. Well, I think that. One of the things that we can see that, you know, goes on in Europe, they have a lot higher density populations in cities, you know, so we need to see how those higher density populations work, full well knowing that our spread out in rural areas, we can do it a little differently. We can, you know, allow for greater freedom, if you will. But yeah, certainly when it comes to transportation in our major metropolitan areas, we need to look to some of those best practices there, and that'll be extraordinarily helpful regarding reducing transmission.
Yeah, 그러니까 미국에서 한번 그 많이 도움이 될 수 있는 게 그 많이 인구들이 같이 막
밀집되어 있으니까.
있으니까 거기서 그 너무 빨리 그 퍼졌을
수도 네네.
그런 건데서 미국에서 그렇게 된다면은 어떻게 뭐 교통서부터 어떻게
네네. 대처 방법들이 네,
그렇죠. 그런 것을 다 어떻게 하느냐. 그것을 받아가지고 여기서 제대로 여기서 할 수 있고 그다음에 미국은 또 시골도 많이 있지만 그 많이 그 거리가 떨어져 있더라고요.
그렇죠.
그래서 그 조심해가지고 그것을 방어할 수 있는 것을 잘 보면은 그 연구를 해가지고 도움이 되게끔 합니다.
그러니까요. 자 그러면은 이제 지금 아직까지 사실은 아주 메가 사이트들이 백신을 맞아주던 페어파크나 이런 곳들이 다 지금 클로즈 됐었단 말이죠. 지금 확진세가 굉장히 가파라지면서 다시 열 계획은 없는지 또 예방접종 그 계획에 대해서 좀 설명을 해 주세요.
And early on this year, when the mega center like a Fairfax opened, so that people get vaccinated fast as I can, quick as I can, if this thing happened again, or you is there plans to open that back up? I know we had that experience, and you are better prepared for this if there's something that happens.
Yeah, I don't think that we're going to go back to that model. Mm-hmm. You know, it had its scale advantage at the time, and I think the best way to think of it is if I have a big floor in front of me and I have to sweep, right? I want to, you know, pull everything into the pile in the middle and get it into the dustbin, right? And then dump it out, right?
Right.
Future events.
Yes.
Future, you know, dirt on my floor, if you will, right? Are going to be more spread out.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Not as easy to sweep all in.
Right.
So the future effort is going to be vacuuming up at the places where it's at, right? And that's how it's going to work in the future because we've, you know, our mass vaccination events have gotten, you know, we've gotten all the use out of them. We've gotten most of the people we can. Now they've become very ineffective in that if you continue to keep it open, you just have this slight trickle of people and all these resources there, right? Well, all those resources there made sense when I had tremendous amounts of people still to scoop in easily. Well, I don't have these big amounts of people to scoop in easily. Right. So I must optimize for reaching out. Mm-hmm. It can be a little bit more expensive, but you know, when it comes to my back-end pieces, I mean, you know, it's not just a person with a needle. Mm-hmm. I have to direct where they're going. I have to schedule them out. Right. I have to make sure that people are where they are, right?
Right.
So there's a lot of back-end. For every one person with a needle, there's 20 or 30 that are going to be doing the back-end piece to make sure the needle gets into the arm. Mm-hmm. So I need to optimize those back-end 20 to get my person with the needle out to all those places to sweep up the little piles that are still left.
Yes, pick up everything up. So, yeah, 그러니까 그 메가센터에 있을 때는 엄청난 많은 분들을 한꺼번에 주사를 맞아야 되기 때문에 그게 중요하고 필요했지만 이제 그것을 다시 열지 않으면 많은 분이 그 주사 백선을 맞았기 때문에 그런데 지금 어디가 있는지 어디 장소로 있는지 따로따로도 가서 찾아가서 해야 되지 그냥 같이 그 다시 그 메가센터 오픈하면은 그렇게 많은 사람 오지 않기 때문에 많이 그 효과가 안 된대요.
비효율적이다 이 말씀이죠.
그렇죠. 찾아가서 주사를 받는 게 더 낫고 더 효과가 되고 빨리 할 수 있고 돈이 좀 들더라도 더 제대로 그 사람들 주사를 맞게 할 수 있다.
네네. 그리고 뭐 이렇게 루스 되는 것도 좀 없고 사실 초창기 때는 워낙에 팬데믹 상황이고 다들 쇼크를 받은 상황이니까 거기에서 뭐 몇 시간씩 기다리면서 샷을 맞기는 했지만 지금은 사실 그런 아주 어수선한 거는 지나갔으니까 각자가 어포이먼에서 낭비되는 거 없이 잘 맞게 하는 것이 더 중요하다. 그러니까 메가 백신 사이트가 열 계획은 없다라는 말씀이에요. 네, 그러면은 이제 뭐 작년 여름처럼 바이러스가 지금 계속해서 뭐 호흡기 질환까지 많아지고 있는데 뭐 물론 당연히 주지사 명령이 먼저겠지만 다시 뭐 셧다운 될 가능성은 없는지 왜냐면 이게 벌써 5만 명인가 8만 명이 지금 넘어섰잖아요. 1일 뭐 감염자 수가 지금 미국 같은 경우는 어떻게 전망하시나요?
Well, I mean, last year was pandemic and there's uncertainty and now we know more about than last year than today and better. So I know everything comes from the governor's order first, but is there any possibility if something like this happening, is there a shutdown again? Is there possibly of a shutdown again?
Yeah, it's important to kind of first address, you know, is there possibilities to have a surge like we had last year?
Yeah.
It is highly unlikely, right? Again, because we talked about folks vaccinated, folks already having the infection, you know, slower transmission in that regard. Okay, so in all likelihood, that reduces that piece. And the other piece is just kind of the rule of law problem that we've had the whole time.
Right.
When the governor started, he allowed counties to have greater latitude to, you know, do as they please, if you will. Some abused it. Some, you know, found creative ways that started to essentially, you know, creep up on some of the courts. And I think probably the flashpoint with the salon owner that essentially violated the orders, was held in contempt, was jailed, and then, you know, there's the response by the executive. But there also was a response by the judicial branch. And it was one of those important things for, you know, myself as a lawyer. I saw, okay, this is going to be a problem going forward, because even if you wanted to, as a governor, go and really clamp down on things, you know, you're the executive branch. There's a legislative branch and there's a judicial branch. And both of them, the legislative branch and the judicial branch, have made it very clear that they will shut down any efforts to really, you know, force vaccination. So, you know, the problem becomes the power of the stick. The governor, even if he wanted to, could not impose the strict type of regime that you see in other countries, or even you might see in a place like Michigan, because even a place like Michigan, their court shut many of those things down. So as a practical matter, we are never going to get to a place again where we have a major shutdown. There can be small interventions, but you know, really, the law doesn't allow for it.
Yeah, that's a great point. 그러니까요. 그래서 지금 작년에 보면은 팬데믹 있으니까 엄청나게 많은 분이 그 바이러스를 받았기 때문에 그렇게 지금은 될 수가 없다고 봅니다. 그렇기 때문에 그렇게 할 필요도 없고 해야 될 이유가 없고 그렇다면은 그 주지사가 그게 하라고 했을 때는 달라스 카운티처럼 달라스 하면 다른 카운티 뭐 대한 그 카운티에서 거기서 그 자유를 줬습니다. 거기서 알아서 하시라고 하는데 그런데 보면은 다른 나라처럼 대통령 명령을 내리면 모든 나라가 전체 움직여야 되는데 여기 미국에서는 좀
그렇죠. 자체의 그 자유를 인정하니까요.
그렇죠. 그렇기 때문에 이 메이저 셧다운은 없을라고 생각을 하면 된다. 왜 그러냐면 저기서 그렇게 하면 많은 것을 경험 속으로 했기 때문에 좋은 것과 나쁜 것을 경험을 했기 때문에
네네.
이것은 안 좋은 일이라고 했기 때문에 셧다운을 할 수가 없다.
네. 그래서 자치구에 약간 좀 자율적으로 이제 네. 좀 효율적으로 좀 움직일 수 있도록 그렇게 좀 한 거죠.
예, 예.
네, 그렇군요. 자, 그러면은 사실 이제 이 텍사스 쪽은 가을 학기부터 대면 100% 대면 수업을 하기로 했단 말이죠.
예.
사실 12살 이하의 어린이를 두고 있는 가정에서는 이게 좀 걱정이 될 것 같은데 어떻게 보시는지요?
Well, as you say, you know, this fall semester comes along that you want to open up the school, and we want to open up the school. But there's a concern about the under 12 that cannot get vaccinated because of the age, and there's a concern for parents for that. What would you say to them, and how would you react to that, respond to that?
Yeah, you know, I don't have a great calming message in that regard,
mm-hmm.
because this is the area of my greatest concern.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a virus does not have consciousness, but like every living thing, right, it is programmed to continue its survival, right, to continue on in generations.
네.
So, if I'm looking at something that wants to survive, I have seen this virus. Mm-hmm. It has not affected children. Very heavily, right? There are some effects, but we see that, you know, transmission is low with kids, and transmission, you know, and when they do have instances of disease, it is not very serious. What if that changes? And that is my great concern. So I want children to be in school, because on the other side of it, we have the test results to show. We have kids that have fallen behind more than a year, much more than a year.
Yes.
And when you fall behind more than a year, it does not take merely another year to catch up. It takes more like 3 or 4 years to catch up.
Wow.
And some will never catch up, right?
Right.
So this is where the balance is. My bet is that the next bad thing to happen in this virus is that it becomes more potent in children. It becomes more dangerous in children, because if I'm a living thing that wants to find the fat of the land, if I want to find the place where I can spread the best, spread the most, and be most effective and stay alive, that would be within that population.
Yes.
That population, you know, will be close to each other. That population, you know, may or may not be masked, and that population has not been affected like that before, right? That seems to be now our most vulnerable.
Mm-hmm.
So what do we do? You know, I think schools are going to have to, you know, be very cautious and cognizant on making sure they don't let, you know, virus in. So all the adults certainly need to be coming in with masks. I think you need to find times and places where kids can be without masks in school, because there has been some testing that has shown it's detrimental in performance, it's detrimental to their social engagement. But on the other hand, we need to find ways to make sure that they're not transmitting like wildfire.
Right.
You know, so it probably means no cafeteria time. It means that your exercise time needs to be outside.
Right.
We're going to have another creative school year, I believe, and I think most ISDs need to, you know, really be. Have already had their plans done on that regard, but they need to be in school.
Yes.
And we just need to be doing all the things we can to avoid transmission. But unfortunately, I think just the biological reality is that is the next group to be affected.
그러니까 참
가장 큰 걱정이죠.
큰 걱정이죠. 예.
네네.
근데 그러면 벌써 1년 넘게 학교를 안 갔습니다.
네네.
그러면 그러면 다시 그걸 캐치업 하려면은 1년이 걸린다는 예, 안 씁니다. 3년, 4년이 걸리죠.
그렇죠. 2배, 3배가 걸리죠.
네. 그런데도 보면은 이 바이러스는
계속 남아 있죠.
나가 있지만 그 제일 위험한 그 그룹 인자 어린애를 찾아서 이 다음 바이러스가 더 위험하고 세고 그 포튼 하다는 건데 더 파워풀하니까 어린애들 그 공격을 한다면은 얼마나 더 위험하지만 그 약도 없고 그렇다면 이것을 더 그 어른들도 더 조심하고 굉장히 크리에이티브 그 근데 좀 과학적으로 어떻게 더 뭐 밖에 가서 애를
네, 야외 활동 만약에 뭐 액티비티가 있다면 야외 활동에서 하고 뭐 식사는 예. 뭐 실내에서는 뭐 못하게 한다든지 일단은 뭐 마스크를 잘 쓰고 그런 조치밖에 없다는 게 참 안타깝기는
합니다. 안타깝고 힘들고 어려운
네네 그러네요. 자 이제 어느덧 벌써 이제 마칠 시간이 됐어요. 마지막으로 저희 한국 청취자분들께 또 이렇게 말씀해 주시고 당부의 말씀 그리고 또 인사 말씀 전해 주시면 좋겠습니다.
Well, thank you so much. Time just flies when you're having fun. So thank you so much for being here. And would you like to say something to our audience or listeners and to say you feel worse?
Oh, yeah. Well, this was a lot of fun. And thank you so much for having me here today. You know, I think that, you know, the Korean culture and those in our Asian cultures have so much to teach Americans, mm-hmm. right? I mean, we are a conglomeration of cultures. That's what, you know, it is to be an American. And if you look throughout our history, mm-hmm. we've been very blessed mm-hmm. by, you know, large group of immigrants coming in and teaching us a new way to do things in certain ways. Mm-hmm. When it comes to connecting with our communities yes. and protecting our communities, we have a lot to learn from our Asian brothers and sisters. Mm-hmm. So I can only encourage you, hey, will you help coach us? We need some coaching right now. We need it because we need to get better at this so we can all you know, get over this virus and start getting back to normal life.
Mm-hmm. Love to work together. Absolutely. 아, 그러니까 이 미국 나라를 보면 그 여러 나라에서 이민을 와가지고 이렇게 문화에 합쳐서 뭉쳐서 그 짬뽕으로 된 거 근데 이 커미션 크게 말씀하신 아시안 문화를 다 참 부러워하고 너무 네. 그 배울 게 있다고
그렇죠.
그래서 네. 배워가지고 같이 할 수 있고 이것을 어떻게 빨리 이것을 마무리가 잘 되고 됐다고 네. 말씀을 하시고
다시 정상적인 생활로 돌아가기를 바란다라고 말씀을 해주셨습니다. 예. 오늘 함께해 주셔서 감사합니다. Thank you for
coming. Thank you so much, man. Thank you.
감사합니다. 감사합니다.